Hello, friends, welcome back for another adventure in Norrath. So I'm playing on the Project 1999 Green server, and I'm over by the toll booth in West Commonlands. So that's circled number 9 on the map for folks that may be new to the game. Yes, somebody actually sent me a tell like, "Why do you do this? This game is really old." And I'm like, "I actually know there are in fact two players." So, I probably went closer to them than I wanted to, but yeah, there's a couple of dangers around the inn, mostly that there's two murderous dwarves right there. I guess they're upset about all the dwarf steaks I've been cooking. And my other danger, if you're a good race, that is Kisdine Gix is around here somewhere, wandering about. So what I'm going to be hunting today is obviously bears. Because I want their sweet, sweet, high quality skins. Not that we're actually going to get a high quality bear skin, but it's nice to think about such things happening on occasion, right? Like, EverQuest is notoriously stingy, at least when it comes to me and bear skins. It's faster, better drop one now that I've talked enough crap. No, a whole lot of nothing. So, my high vibe. High-value targets are going to be things like giant spiders. Easily fear kite those. And I'm kind of hanging close to here just in case a bigger, meaner bear walks up. Or, there are some. Geez, fizzles for days. It's my new name. And what I kind of do is throw my poison bolt in, throw my fear in, and hopefully it doesn't path straight to the guards, which it totally basically did. Good thing is they're asleep on the job. Yeah. Normally I was killing a little bit further out. But anyways, yeah, this is how I'm going to spend probably the next couple of levels, chasing huge spiders and such. So much fun. And now, yeah, as you can see, he's basically dead. And it's just time for me to continue meditating. So thanks to Dark Pact, I am able to kill pretty efficiently at this level. Damn, a spider silk. I'm gonna totally attempt to do tailoring. See, that's one of my other problems is these dudes are totally killing some of my spiders. And there's an example of something I'm worried about killing me. There's an example of something I would like to kill. Let's go up there and get that younger bear. And pulled in, and I'm gonna pull him a little bit further this way to prevent a scenario where the guards totally kill him. Poison bolts in, and that's almost like a free fear, actually, is kind of the cool thing about it. And then when you stand, pretty much instantly doesn't care about you anymore. I'm gonna kind of run with my pet, and my damn Dark Pact wore off, of course. Just let my pet do his thing. Oh my god, I'm back there. It does suck at this level because your snares don't last long, your fears don't really last long. None of your stuff really lasts long, to be honest with you. So it is challenging on occasion. But the good news is my pet can go toe-to-toe with these things for at least a little bit. I'm gonna add a plains cat here in a second, maybe. Okay, young Kodiak, you're supposed to run away at some point, dude. Like, for realsies. And there's someone else chilling around here. He is red. He must need some silk. Oh my god, I got some words of eradication. Chunk of meat, chunk of meat. Grizzly bear skin. I think vendors for a little bit. See, I'm like basically always encumbered. So I'm gonna have to go chase that plains cat now. Damn it. I need Spirit of Wolf. I would love to go to the Druid Ring, but I also don't want to die. Okay. Plains cat should be like damn it, resisted. Oh, poison bolt you cat, I don't care. Try to pull it back over here. There's a skeleton kill in a second. Yeah, so I mean this is a pretty good little hunting spot at level 9. I feel very comfortable here on the Necro. I felt less so trying to solo here on my Enchanter. Things just did not go as planned pretty much ever in the scheme of this. But yeah, I do have to keep an eye out for werewolves. And I don't know if that Wandering Dragoon is a thing on P99 or if that was like a later expansion. But yeah, I'm not too worried about running into him either. He'll be like, sup, homie. Whereas other people will have a very bad day. Need some weight reduction bags, like nobody business. And I have that giant halberd I'm carrying about that I will eventually use. I just want to find. Actually, what it really is I only have about an hour to play, so I feel like it's kind of wasteful to use my sweet, ridiculous damage pet at that point. When I don't have any time to actually play. Hey, Blue Con Rattlesnake, you gonna die? And these are much worse than a Tree Snake and Nectulos, so that should be able to kill that with minimal challenge and minimal help for me. Gonna chill and meditate while he stabby stabs. Yeah, so of all the places I have hunted, I will say this is one of the more peaceful ones. It's not anything like East Commons where you've got millions of people running about. And it is, I think a little bit of it is like the danger factor, and like people like to hang out in East Commons because they go sit at the tunnel and beg for buffs all day. Which, don't get me wrong, if I'm in the area, I might go ask once, but yeah, I don't like, I mean, the game is hard, don't get me wrong, and having buffs is nice for sure, but you don't like have to have them, I guess, is the term I'm gonna use. Young Kodiak, way over there. Giant Kodiak over should we say a not so young Kodiak? I'm not going to travel that far away from my safe zone. There is a rattlesnake. He is green, though. There's a giant spider. Perfect. All right. Bam. Throw a fear in. One thing I will say is that this level of fear is definitely pretty taxing on your mana pool. A lot of it, doing having to do with the fact I don't have a mana pool effectively. Really don't like that Kodiak over there. I feel like he's going to totally sneak up behind me and straight bite me in the ass when I'm playing. Though I should be more worried about ghouls and werewolves, because that's also a thing out here. Lots of ghouls running about and whatnot. The same green snake, yes. I might kill it just so I might get something better. Running around. That rattlesnake. Next giant spider. Perfect. Sit there and let him stab that. I chill and meditate. So, some exciting news. I am planning to start doing some live streams on both YouTube and Twitch again. Kind of took a break from it as I was like, okay, I need to figure out what the heck I'm doing with all this stuff before I go forth and make all this content. I've started trying out some new thumbnail methods where I put like little snarky comments on there, which is like effectively what they tell you with thumbnails is like don't put more than asshole spider. They tell you basically don't put more than like 3 to 4 words on them. Oh, you son of a bitch. Don't go too close. Don't do it. Don't do it. Perfect. These guards do not care at all about their citizens. Like, it's good to know. Yeah. Okay. Good. Dark pack back up. Oh, that little bastard turned around and bit the shit out of my pet there. Or silk. Yay. I don't know how much silk I'm going to need when I start doing tailoring, but I feel like it's going to be a lot. So, yeah, I'm going to take a quick meditate break. So, pause. Turn shortly. Alright, got me a plains cat unlock. And my pet should make pretty quick work of that, so not really going to bother with much else. So there is actually an undead tower over there. I'll probably make a video about that as well. Though, pretty sure there's lots of mummies and ghouls spawning in that bastard, so definitely not fun. I feel like I could kill a yellow con asp, probably. Let's find out, shall we? Not likely to poison bolt the guy, but whatever. Oh, so I started running. Pet, 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 pet. Almost gated. Oh shit. This is not looking good. Of course he's gonna resist my fear. Pet, I need you to like pick up the pace, friend. Clinging darkness back on there. I'm gonna throw a life spike in there just to get this thing to flee range quickly. So yes, we can kill a yellow. But a little bit riskier than I would have liked. But it does give you a tiny... Killing a yellow does give you just a tiny bit more experience, so... It's not bad to do it every once in a while. That should be a regular... Is blue for after him. Yeah, this place has a pretty good bit of stuff wandering around for, you know, pretty much just me here. Scene other than that one monk who was after silk. Maybe if I go stand conveniently close to the druid reigns, the druid will come bless me with buffs. Kill me. I see a halfling. He's probably upset though because I did kill like all of his friends. Oops. They totally deserved it. Totally. Also, shout out to this awesome cat here. I'm gonna boop a snoot. He has been chilling with me all day. Make videos and play. I've been playing Heroes of the Storm again quite a lot, actually. Even though it's a quote-unquote dead game, I still quite enjoy playing it. Even though, you know, I'm not going to say I'm terrible at it, but I'm not going to claim to be good either. That's just reality of that. I really want to kill this little bastard. If only I had magic weapon. Well, go back over here. Get up some spiders. So while I run without my Spirit of the Wolf, I'm going to go ahead and pause for a second. Alright, it didn't take me very long to find a sweet spider to kill. I think these spiders are right at like level 8-ish, 7-8-ish. So they are not terribly difficult to kill. Please, spider. I have to re-snare him. And my sweet skin like diamond wore off, which is fine, because I haven't really been having to jump in there and melee very much. Necromancer kind of has that benefit. You, assuming you have mana, not going to really have to worry about that sort of thing too much. See a nice darkweed snake over there to kill. Oh, look, he has nothing. Go kill this one then. Fine. Oh man, someone straight shanked Kizdeen Giggs, yo. Well, I'm looting him. Might be something I want. I don't know if that's... Sounds like it's time to do some research. Like, what the hell is that for? That poison bolt in. That fear in. Before it kills my pet. Or not. Fine, too. It's gonna life tap him. It's gonna be a quick med break after this for sure. Man, this dude's been looking for protection in the Glades for a really long time. I wish I had it. I'd hook him up. I don't. I do need to actually, like, you know, level Kristana one day. He is, you know, tragically still level 45 as I film this. Almost tempted to lure that bear over here just to kill it off, but eh. Anyways, folks, thanks for hanging out with me over in West Commonlands. I know it's so much fun watching me kill spiders, yeah. But don't worry, this necromancer will soon do great things, damn it. I'm determined. I want to get her leveled up a little bit. I kind of am enjoying this a little bit more than playing Kristana right now, so that's why you've been seeing a lot of Kristana videos. But don't worry, she'll be back soon, too. I have her camped in Wakening Lands, totally buffed up, ready to go try some stuff out there. But anyways, thanks again for watching. Appreciate you stopping by to check out my adventures in the Wrath. And I hope everyone will join me on my next adventure.